Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. My name is Vieco, and today we're gonna be diving into some actual modeling in Max. So in the last video, I showed how to do some basic spline manipulations, some shortcuts, but now we're gonna be modeling a TV. So in Max, there is pretty much two ways how you can model things. One is with splines, the other one is with polygons. I'm gonna be focusing on the polygon thing. So yeah, let's start modeling some TVs. So before you start modeling anything, here is the issue. When you go in your viewport and you create a box, that box is 21.7 something, 31.9 something, 21.9 something, meters, centimeters, feet, yard, you don't know what units you're dealing with. So to tackle this problem, just go to customize, unit setup, and here you have the display unit setup, meaning what will be displayed here. So I'm in Europe, so I'm gonna set to metric. If you're in US, set to US standard or wherever you live. So I'm gonna click on metric now, and centimeters will be displayed here. You can choose that to be millimeters, meters, kilometers, it's up to you. So when you click OK, this box that I created, as you can see, is 2.17 centimeters, 3 centimeters, 2 centimeters. And now we can actually start, building the actual TV. By the way, just a quick tip, if you're dealing with turbo large scenes, like highways that have 20 kilometers of size, maybe, a box this big that's 2 centimeters is not ideal for you. So instead of you scrolling back, until you reach your freaking highway of 10 kilometers, what you can do, go to customize, unit setup, system unit setup, and this is how big the object created in the scene, like what dimension that object will be. So if you're dealing with bigger scenes, you can here go with meters or kilometers, and then when you create a box this big, it's actually going to be, 200 meters or whatever. This is just an orientation thing. So I'm gonna be modeling like a generic 55-inch TV. So how do we go about it? So I'm just gonna go here to the bottom right, maximize viewport toggle, or just hit Alt W, and I will see all four viewports. You see that? Alt W, Alt W, like wherever you hover, it will just, you see like wherever you right click, you see how the viewports is selected? When you click Alt W, it's gonna maximize that viewport. Here, boom, here, boom, see, front. So first, I'm gonna start with creating a box. This will pretty much be our display. So I did this. This is the box that I created. So the width of my screen, I want that to be 121 centimeters and the height will be 70 centimeters. Go to your modify panel here. For your width, you can type 121 centimeters and for your height, you may wanna type 70. Okay, so now we got this. This is our screen. For the thickness of our screen, let's go with, 3 centimeters, right? This is it. When you do modeling, there is one technical aspect that you always need to kind of consider, and that's, the structure of your model. So there's this beautiful thing in Max that's called a wireframe. So if you go to the default shading here, you have a thing, like these are different display methods of how this viewport can be displayed. So let's click on the edged faces. Now, as you can see, you got this kind of wireframe here. If you go here and if you click wireframe override, you're only gonna be viewing the wireframe. To make this a little bit more clear, if I create a teapot now, you see how the teapot looks? It's like full in wireframe. Now if you go to wireframe again and turn off wireframe override, this is what I get. You can see the object plus you see the wireframe. But this thing is a pain in the ass to switch. Whenever you need to go there, it's always, wireframe, phased wire, don't do that. Shortcuts. You have three also most used shortcuts, and that's F2, F3, and F4. So what do they do? F3 switches between full-on wireframe and, faces wireframe. F4 just turns off that phases wireframe and just shows the clean object. F2 is the thing that we're going to be using mid-modeling. We're going to see what it does. So yeah, again, click F3, F4, see what they do. My TV, let me just select that. So I've set the length to be 3 centimeters, width 121, height 70. So let me just hit Alt W to go to all the viewports. I can now click this button here. You see like here on the bottom right, this upper button. What will that do? It will center this object across all four viewports. So look at this. Click that, boom. You kind of see it everywhere, Now, let's do some actual modeling. Now, to access the whole, creation thing of the, or modeling thing of an object, you need to convert that object to a polygon editing object. By the way, in case you don't know what polygons are, pretty much you see like here, this giant, you know, face is one polygon, you know, this one here is a second polygon, so third. The same like when I create a teapot, like all the little square parts here, all of those are polygons. So we want to get into the polygon editing mode. Click on the TV, right click, and you have convert to. So here you can choose convert to editable poly. Click on that, and now remember, like when you selected the box, you would go here and you would have, you know, you would go to the modify panel and you would have your length, width, height. Well, that's all gone now, and now it's pretty much replaced with this monstrosity. Good luck with that. So in editable poly, you're pretty much editing, you know, polygons, points, various like edges, etc. So how do you access those things? If you click, so under the selection, this is the main thing that you need to learn. So you have vertex, edge, border, polygon, and element. So what does each do? Click on the vertex. Let me just make this TV some other color. So just, you know, I'm just gonna click on the little blue color here, and I'm gonna change that to be, let's say, this yellow color. Okay, so vertex mode. If I zoom in here, and if I click on the vertex mode, I'm gonna get these little blue dots. These blue dots are called vertices. Vertices are pretty much points in 3D. If I click on the second one, which is edge, now I can actually select an actual edges. So as you can see here, it's like edge, edge, right? If I go to the border mode we cannot activate now, because border is when you have holes in the object, it's just gonna like make an edge selection of the actual hole. Next, we got polygon mode. So when you click on the polygon mode, when you select a polygon, you see, these are polygons. Polygon, polygon, etc. Now, remember when I told you that we're going to be using, you know, F3, F4 to select, you know, to kind of view the wireframe and shaded. And then I told you that there's actually an F2 that you can use. So look what F2 does. We have polygon selected. And when I click F2, it's just visually going to remove, you know, the red big selection marker. And you're just going to see it like this. So look at this. If I click on here, F2, it's just this. It's still the same thing. It's just a visual representation. Now the funny part starts. So you can notice that when my polygons are selected, I have this, you know, kind of move, rotate, scale, gizmo thingy. And pretty much wherever I click, you have that stuff here also. So now, look at this. If I click on the top and if I go here, you're actually modifying that polygon, meaning you're actually modeling now. You're now reducing the sizes. Look, if I go to the vertex mode, if I select one point here and just move it, see this? Magic. The same thing goes with edges. So if I click on an edge, I can like move it here. Gonna press my E to go to the rotate mode. Now I can rotate it. You know, it's just it's crazy. If I go to scale, you can just scale it, you know, do whatever you like. This is now like welcome to modeling in Max. And last we have the element mode here. Element will pretty much just select the whole object. Why is that here? Like, why can't you just, you know, go to the polygon mode and, you know, like just select all of them, or just click Control A and this will just select all the polygons? Why this? Because each object in Max can actually have multiple objects within itself, right? So you can have, you know, a chair that's all kind of collapsed into one object. And then when you click this element mode, you can separately select, you know, one leg, second leg, seat, back, etc. Okay, to model the TV, let's select the front face. We need some sort of border in which, you know, like where the screen is gonna be. So first, we need to define that border. So if you look on the right, you have tons of options here, which you can use. Now, I'm just gonna collapse some of them. So let's go to this one. In the later videos, by the way, I'm gonna like in detail explain all these options, but let's just, you know, cover the ones that we need right now. Of course, click on the buttons and see what they do. Experiment. So edit polygons. We're gonna be here. Here you have an option that's called an inset. When you click on the inset option, you can see that your mouse cursor kind of changes. You see, like before it was this because we're in the scale mode. You see, like when I go to the move, it's this. When I go to the rotate, it's this. Now, if I click on the inset, it's gonna become this. Now, when you click and drag, you're actually adding some extra edges to the whole story. I mean, this already kind of reminds you of a TV for a start. If you want to be kind of more precise on how much of these edges are you creating, you can notice that like next to all of these features, extrude, bevel, bridge, inset, there are these little boxes, like these little icons. If you click on that icon now, so next to the inset, like here, you can actually define how much you want to inset this whole thing. So I want to inset this whole thing, let's say by 2 centimeters. I'm just going to type 2, hit OK. Now this is inserted 2 centimeters. Click OK button there, and that's it. This is our selection for the screen. Now the screen is always pushed in a little bit, and then you have the surrounding plastic. So click on the extrude. And now when you click and long press and just move your mouse, this is what you're doing. You're actually extruding the polygon in and out. So we're just going to extrude it a little bit in like this. Right click to finish the action, the magic right click. Again, this little box, it pretty much tells you how much exactly of the extrusion do you want. But yeah, this is fine for now. So this is our screen. Now, if I want to model some legs of this screen, this is what I'm gonna do. As you can see, our screen is kind of lying on the floor, like this is the floor ground, right? We need to kind of raise it up. So I'm just gonna raise it up, let's say up to there, because I know my legs are 10 centimeters tall. But hey, how do I know if I raised this thing exactly by 10 centimeters? Because I'm pretty much just eyeballing here. I'm just gonna control Z, like undo the whole thing. So take a look at here. You got these numbers here. This is your pretty much like coordinates orientation thing. So look, when I increase this up, you see here, 12 centimeters height, 29 centimeter height. So what you can do now, you can just double click here and type 10. And now this is 10 centimeters above the ground. Also, there is one other method to kind of access this area. And that's if you right click on the move tool, you're gonna get this, this little window. And here you can actually type also the numbers that you need. It says, you see like 0.3, 1, 5, 10. It's the same values here. So yeah, you can experiment with that. Now let's model the legs. So for the legs, I'm gonna create one of those legs that's just like a square stand, and it has like two legs like this. So I'm gonna create a box here like this. I'm gonna make the length and width of the box to be 3, 3, and then the height is just gonna be 10. And let's leave it like that, right? This is kind of a basic stand for now. But now we wanna kind of edit this, these legs. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna right click, convert to editable poly, and now I can start editing this or modeling this. So one thing that I wanna do, I'm gonna go to my polygon mode. I wanna select, the front polygon, and I wanna kind of make it, like narrower so that it kind of, tilts in. And now I'm gonna move to my scale tool, and I'm just gonna scale it under the X axis. I'm just gonna press F3 to kind of clearly see what's happening, right? So I'm just gonna move it like this. Okay, I actually want to, move it maybe a little bit in, just, so that it looks like that. Now, I want to add some sort of legs. So we got the little stand, but I want to make like some legs for it. And remember how I used the whole extrude option to like extrude in the screen? We're going to be using that here. So if I select this and this, and now if I go to my extrude, well, these are not really the legs that I want. You see, like I want those legs to be much lower. So what I can do, I'm gonna go to my edge mode. I'm gonna select all my kind of vertical edges. You see, like all the vertical edges are selected. And now I'm gonna use this awesome feature here called connect. So if you click on the connect, look what this will do. It's just gonna create like one set of edges. But now I want generally these legs to be much shorter. I don't want them to be, this tall. So what I'm gonna do, just gonna lower this down. So lower this down like this. And now you wanna go to your polygon mode. And now you can select, this polygon and this polygon. And now I'm gonna hit the extrude, but the little square here, or I don't know, I can actually use this too. You know what? I'm just gonna use the little box here. So here you just want to type, the number that you want. Let's say I want my legs to be 30 centimeters. Hit OK. And that's pretty much it. Now to go out of the editable poly mode, you just need to turn it off here. One good indicator, like, are you in the polygon editing mode, or are you out of the polygon editing mode, is the color of this. So you see how editable poly is now has a blue thing? That means that you're out of the modeling mode. When you are in the modeling mode, you just lose the blue thing. So press F3 to view our model. This is the little screen that we got. If I want to make this kind of stand more fancy, because I doubt it will stand like this, what I can do, I'm just going to select the legs here, go to vertex mode here, and I'm just going to select all the bottom vertices, and I'm just going to move it all back, you know, like this. Is this kind of logical? I think it is. Maybe like this. Okay. And there you go. You got yourself a first TV. Congratulations. And that's it for today, guys. So today we kind of dived into some basic polygonal modeling. Next time I'm going to be explaining some spline modeling, and we're going to be modeling a lamp. So stay tuned and see you in the next video. Bye.